What's up guys, it's Collin. In today's video, we're talking all about selecting the best cleanup crew for your bioactive tank. So our first contender in our cleanup crew is gonna be our tropical springtail. This is the smallest member of our cleanup crew, and I definitely recommend these guys for several reasons. So if we get a close-up of these guys, let's see, there's hundreds and hundreds of these guys. These are super tiny. One of the main benefits of these guys is they're gonna do all the small tasks in your tank. So these guys are really good about consuming things that other parts of your cleanup crew won't. So things like algae, mold, mildew, small things like masses of bacteria and things like that, these are gonna be absolutely wonderful for. Another thing with these guys is the wetter the conditions, the better. So in a super tropical or humid tank, these guys are gonna be perfectly suited and feel perfectly at home. And for that reason, because they're not gonna interfere with any of your other animals or with your other parts of your cleanup crew, I definitely recommend tropical springtails for all types of enclosures. Now there are different varieties of springtails that are called arid springtails. We don't usually sell those in our store, but for most of your animals, you're gonna be able to get away with the tropical pink springtails with no issue. And for that reason, I love these guys. The second member of our cleanup crew is gonna be our isopods. So there's about 10,000 different species of isopod, and there's about 150 of them that are currently in the exotic slash reptile hobby. These guys are gonna be consuming a different type of material in our terrarium. So these are gonna consume decaying wood matter, decaying plant matter, fungi, things like that. These are also gonna be the ones that are consume a majority of your animal droppings and things like that. Now there are many different varieties of isopods, so it's important to choose the right kind. Here we have some dairy cows, I believe. Now these are a Laevis species. So there are all different sizes of isopods. These, of course, are a larger species. Some species I don't recommend for certain types of animals. So for example, if you're doing like a tarantula enclosure or a soft scale gecko enclosure, I would definitely recommend using like a dwarf variety, like a dwarf white or a dwarf purple isopod. The reason for that is sometimes with these larger species of isopod, like your Laevis and your armadillium and the bigger varieties, they can actually become kind of carnivorous if they're underfed. So in general, if you don't have enough biological matter in your tank to help subsist them, I do recommend supplements basically. So over here, I have some different items. So definitely, we sell live oak leaves as well as magnolia leaves. This is a great secondary food source if you don't have a sufficient amount of biological material built into a developing terrarium. And I also do recommend, as far as amendments, we also have our horticultural charcoal. This can be a great amendment to mix into your living soil as far as your springtails go as well. It's great as a culture medium as well. And then of course we have our pre-mix, like it's our repti-soil blend here. This is some sand and carbon already added to it. This is gonna be really great to start off as our base layer for your amendments as far as our invertebrates go. The next part of our cleanup crew that I usually recommend is gonna be our bottom dweller. So these guys are gonna be our kind of the unseen heroes of our terrarium. And of course that would be our red wigglers. So these of course are a type of worm. So the great thing about red wigglers is they're self-multiplying first off. So they're gonna be like self-sustaining. The second part about these guys are gonna help to not only aerate our soil mass because they're consuming all kinds of organics and then secondarily, you know, transitioning it into worm castings. So that's gonna, number one, it's gonna help to fertilize our plants. But number two, it's gonna help to prevent root rot. If we're getting rid of all that organics and excess moisture out of our root zone and our soil layer, it's gonna help to keep things fresher, more aerated. This will also help with the fact of it's gonna keep our mix fluffier and lighter. It's gonna help with isopod movement and isopod, you know, behaviors in the soil and things like that as well. So for a bottom layer of our cleanup crew, I definitely recommend adding a red wiggler culture to your terrarium. So for honorable mention as part of our cleanup crew, I do have an excellent addition you could add for certain types of terrariums as well. These of course would be our standard mealworms. So these of course are a beetle larvae. These are great for more arid terrariums, like if you wanted to do a bioactive tank for a leopard gecko or for a bearded dragon, and this is twofold. So number one, these serve as an excellent food source. And then in the adult beetle stage, these are still soft enough to be consumed as like an enrichment type of feeder for your animal. So these are excellent. And of course, these are also gonna eat any uneaten food scraps in your terrarium. So like for example, if your bearded dragon gets greens everywhere and it's bioactive, if that gets into the soil blend, these guys along with your isopods are gonna be an excellent way of consuming some of that if you're not getting all the small pieces. And then secondarily, like I said, once they metamorphosize, basically, the beetles are actually consumable and they're soft enough. There are larger species of beetle. Like, for example, superworms. So those beetles, their exoskeletons are super hard. So I would not recommend those as a feeder. They're not easily digestible. So please do not try that with, like, superworms. Just because most animals don't have the capacity to digest that kind of stuff. And they could get impacted if they were to eat some, like, actual superworm beetles. If you have any questions about selecting the best cleanup crew for your terrarium, be sure to ask a staff member. We'd be happy to assist you in selecting the best team.